Hi students, welcome to Bosco Campus Vision. Let us continue the poem Enterprise. Look at the lines of the poem. Another phase was reached when we were twice attacked and lost our way. A section claimed its liberty. Yes, now that group of pilgrims, they reached the another stage of their journey. And they divided into groups. They were twice attacked during the course of their pilgrimage. That means they attacked each other two times and forgot their aim and destination. They lost their unity and strength. At this stage of their journey, they did not think about the initial exaltation and the purpose of their pilgrimage. As a result of this disharmony, they lost their way. A section claimed its liberty. That means being unsatisfied with their leader, some quit the group. They want freedom and liberty. Yes, look at the sentence, to leave the group. I tried to pray. Our leader said he smelt the sea. A group of pilgrims left the group. The poet, being helpless, could not do anything and thus starts praying. The leader of the group said that he smelt the sea. Actually, he is trying to give others false hope that the sea is near. Thus, he considers that they are reaching their destination. Here in this stage of their pilgrimage, we can understand that they lost their aim and destination. Just considers sea as their destination. That shows the futility of their journey. Look at the poem. We noticed nothing as we went, a straggling crowd of little hope, ignoring what the thunder meant, deprived of common needs like soap. Some were broken, some merely bent. However, soon they realized that it was a false hope from the leader, as they did not notice anything on their way. They were now a group of aimless wanderers. They discovered that their deeds were ordinary and commonplace. They had now forgotten their aim with which the group had started the journey. And ignoring what the thunder meant. Here the pilgrims could not hear the thundering of inner self. That means they could not hear the self-realization of their initial exaltation and aim. They lost that vigor and energy. They ignored it. They were now without even petty things like soap. Some were broken, some merely bent. They were totally exhausted. Some of them could not walk anymore, while some bent down with pain. Thus, the enthusiasm with which they had started the journey faded away, and their burden is unbearable. When finally we reached the place, we hardly knew why we were there. The trip had darkened every face. Our deeds were neither great nor rare. Home is where we have to gather grace. At last, they reached the place. Finally, they reached their destination, but they did not know why we were there. There is no joy of fulfillment on their faces. They wonder why they undertook the journey, as it now seemed to be meaningless, futile and worthless. They forget their noble aim in the beginning of their journey. Each and everyone is desperate, tired and hopeless. They found nothing heroic in their journey. They realize that what they have done is neither heroic nor rare. At last, the poet realized that living at home with inner satisfaction is the biggest achievement of all. The narrator discovered that we can get God's grace at home. Serving one's own family by practicing virtues at home is the way to please God. Hence, the journey that started with enthusiasm ends with grief, despair, regret, and hopelessness. The last line of the poem explains that one cannot achieve real happiness by undertaking such a long journey, but by doing the right and good things in life. Doing good to the mankind makes more sense, and it makes a better way than going to a pilgrimage to gather God's grace. Let us conclude the poem. This poem is full of irony. People who wanted to exalt their minds became hopeless at the end. The pilgrims wanted the pilgrimage to lighten their burden, but the pilgrimage itself became a burden. Here in this poem, Ezekiel employs very simple language. The poem consists of only 6 stanzas, and there is nothing extraordinary in the form of the poem. Both the journey and the conclusion in the last line of the poem are metaphorical, and it is said that there are 2 central metaphors in this poem. One is pilgrimage and the other one is home. One explanation says we don't need to go to a pilgrimage for the spiritual needs. The God is inside us, so we need to our inner self. Another interpretation suggests that we should take care of the people around us and earn their love and respect in order to lead a happy and meaningful life. Some critics also suggest that the word home indicates the poet's commitment towards his home in Mumbai. There are many critics who feel that this poem is a search for the meaning of life, life's journey. Our life also begins with high expectations, but we often deviate from the aim or face tough challenges in the middle and finally reach the last stage without much achievement, like this poem. Students, hope all of you understand this poem. There is a homework for you. Write a critical appreciation of the poem Enterprise. And this poem is important because so many times university essay questions came from this particular poem. So please go through the class and do your homework properly and send back to me. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you again.